Hello and welcome to this little game called Hatred. I call it a little game because, well, it's just a top-down shooter. There's, you know, not much more to it. The only gameplay I've seen of this video is the gameplay trailer, although I imagine everybody on YouTube is probably going to look at this video just because of all the controversy surrounding this game. I've purposely not looked at anything. I've not played the game before, and I've only just got it now and just installed it, so I have no idea how this game runs, besides a little tutorial level that I just did dead, and I tweaked the details accordingly just to get the game to even run. Right. So, about this game, it's got controversy. Basically, you are just a guy who has to kill, well, not has to, but wants to kill everybody. Now, the line that separates this game from every other game that allows you to kill people is that in this one, the objective is to kill the people, whereas in most other games, they're just optional. Like in GTA, is the classic example I'm sure everybody's using. GTA, you can run up to someone, smack them right in the face, and shoot them and mow them down. You can do that, but you choose to do that. You're never asked to do that. This game, however, you're pretty much asked to. But they're all walking targets, so, plus at the end of the day, this is a video game. So, let's get underway. Alright, convenient having a bus stop. Oh, executions. Yay. Okay, so I'm going to be looking at this from a video game perspective. I'm definitely not going to be looking at this from the controversy perspective, because I own over 3,500 games. Over 3,500 games, I've seen and played it all. Well, not all of it, but the vast majority of it. So I know what video games entail and what can make a good video game. Basically, a good video game is a game you can enjoy. Question is, can you enjoy this game? Ooh. I love how you're not... The AI could be a little bit better. Alright. I believe the health bar at the bottom is the health. Come on, cop. Get out of that driveway. Would appear bullets can't penetrate cars. Right. Let's flank him. The camera could be a little bit better. No, I could play a little bit better. That's probably a good... Why are you hovering around? Are you a cop? Nope, you're not a cop. You're just Sherlock Holmes. Come here! Now, I don't really know the controls much, besides the ones in the tutorial. Honestly, I don't know what the hell I'm doing. I'm assuming just kill everybody is the objective. So, we're gonna do that. As for the graphic style... Nice. I can't say I don't like this graphic style. Yeah, black and white with the only colours being like explosions and stuff, like flashing lights of cars and fire, I believe, as it's shown in the gameplay trailer. Yep, fire. Ooh, nice. And that destruction physics says it all. That stuff's just beautiful. Alright, so we need to kill you. You can turn these executions off, I believe. There is an option in the settings that actually mentions executions. Let me just have a look. Options, gameplay. I don't know what Are You Drunk is, but safe executions only. I imagine that just turns them off. I mean, my crosshair red because I need more color on my screen. Why'd you have to reload now? I should have checked my ammo count. You even FPS, Dan? Well, not FPS. Shut up. Flanked! Wrecked. Alright. Seems I've cornered myself. Probably a bad idea. How much ammo have we got? 30. Oh! There's cops coming in to say hi to me. I actually don't have that much ammo left. So I probably should get one soon. Do I have any grenades? Probably not. Right, sprint out of it. Let's get the heck out of here. Reload the weapon.
What's going on?
What's going on? I don't know. It would appear I'm having an episode. So yeah, while I understand the controversy around this game, naturally you're going to be like, whoa, what the hell? But as far as I'm aware, this game has an adults-only rating, which is only reserved for porn games. and games that are extremely adult-related. Like, what was it, the original Manhunt, or was that Manhunt 2? I can't quite remember. But, yeah, basically it's got an adult-only rating, meaning that no children should ever play this game, and to be honest, I don't think children should ever... But then again, I'm one of those people who don't think children should play 18-rated games, regardless of what parents say, because what the hell do parents know? I'm kidding. I'm saying offensive things because I'm playing an offensive game. Anyway, what do I think of this game so far? A generic, if you replaced all the civilians with aliens, I genuinely think this was Alien Shooter. But look, with Alien Shooter 3, there we go. I'm sure you guys have heard of Alien Shooter. If you look on Steam, there's Alien Shooter, Alien Shooter 2, and Conscription and all that stuff. They are twin stick shooters where you run around like this and you shoot aliens. That's essentially it. It would appear I'm out of ammo. Let's check out the icons on the mini-map. Maybe it'll lead us to a weapon. I think I just picked up ammo for that. Ah, I see. The little white icon is ammo. As you hear from the little sound. Hey, shoot. I'm not shooting anyone at the moment. Little pistol there. So I got plenty of pistol ammo. How do you change weapon? Oh, scroll wheel. Is it scroll wheel? It would appear to be scroll wheel. All right. Whoa. Calm down. Oh, he's got a shotgun. Let's go get that. It looks like we're out of ammo for our AK anyway. We've got like 8 bullets left. Oh, apparently I can hold the shotgun as well anyway. Fair enough. Let's get inside the vehicle and see what the driving physics are like. I do like the destruction in this game. Ravage the market. Okay. Hello, I am the police. What appears to be the problem? It would appear I am the problem. To be honest, I don't understand the massive controversy because, well, we all remember the controversy surrounding the mission No Russian. You guys remember No Russian, right? From Call of Duty? Oh, bloody Nora. Cops are really stepping up the game. But yeah, in that mission, you were tasked to infiltrate a terrorist group, and the terrorist group attacked a airport, mowing down probably a few hundred people. It is optional, however, you don't have to pull the trigger. You're not penalized for not pulling the trigger. I suppose there's that. Oh, I think these are the missions. Oops. Yeah, run, run! Oh, sorry. It would appear I'm the bad person. That kick animation! Ugh. Free ammo. But anyway, yeah, this essentially... Is this worse than that? Probably. But it's like comparing apples to oranges. This is a twin-stick shooter. Most of the games are either third-person or first-person. This is just a twin-stick shooter. Waste the party. They have no idea what is coming! All I have to do is picture them as terrorists, and this game doesn't seem so bad. Stop resisting arrest! I'm a rogue cop! I'm Dirty Harry. And these guys are all triads. Oh, Russian Mafia. Yeah. So many people. Is that a cop there? I see you. Oh, can we go upstairs?
All the flock in the same barn. Birds of a feather.
Are they trying to shoot me through the... Guys... I've got you cornered. You have to be exceptionally good in order to get around me now. There's only one way up here. Was that a civilian that just ran up these stairs? Regardless. Oh, I'm actually getting pretty low on ammo. Ooh, this game's a lot more difficult than it lets on. Yes, you are bleeding. Can't aim very well downstairs. Whoa, he took up arms against me. Excellent. That's what I like to see. That guy was a little running gunny, weren't he? I guess he wanted to play hero. There is a window behind me. If they were clever, they would flank me. Whoa! I like all the physics. I do love the detail of this game. If this game replaced all the civilians with something else, it could be an exceptional top-down shooter. It really could be. But right now, it appears that this game was developed to create controversy. But it was actually developed really well. So it's not actually just a really crappy Unity game that was just made to create controversy for the sake of controversy. Oh, ran you over. So, I'm not going to say I'm not enjoying this game. It has its appeal, I guess. If you look at this game through the eyes of these are all moving targets, they're robots or whatever. It's oh snap! And I was just ambushed. Nice. If you added zombies to this game, then I'd be extremely interested. Oh crap! Let's get a little bit of health back. Don't walk out here, civilian. Look, I've just shot at you. Look. I think this is the... Is this the police precinct? I ain't got a clue. Two. One. May as well take him out. Get out and reload. Whoa, who's shooting me? Oh, is that the cop? Alright. Let's get some ammo. It seems I've got plenty of pistol ammo now. Whoa! I would say the controls aren't the best. It feels like the frame rate's been capped at a low frame rate. Oh, snap! I wasn't paying attention to my health. Like I said, the UI could be better. The UI in this game, it could actually be a lot better. Oop. Hey, bullets. Because you're mostly looking at the top middle, round here. I don't know how you can see that. Just basically look for my little red crosshair. Okay, I'm mostly looking around my character and where my crosshair is. I'm not glancing at the bottom. It's not very noticeable. The minimap's more noticeable than the UI. If they had a little black background around it, I suppose it'd look a little bit better. But, that's just a little grab of me. Maybe it's only me that thinks that, but the UI could be a lot better. You may notice that the health bar's actually red. And you'd be like, hey, what, you can see that. Yes, I know I can see that, but I can't see it in the corner of my eye, so I don't have a very good idea of how much health I actually have left. Unless I take my eyes away from the game up here and look down towards my health, which could then leave me open to being ambushed and shot. What would I think is a better alternative? I don't know, having a health bar circle around my character maybe? But then again, that would give it a more video gamey feely anyway, if you gave me a health bar around my character. There you go, for the health. Oh, ammo. Ammo! I've been playing a lot of Mercenaries 2 lately, so I might be making a few references. Alright, so we are about 20 to 15 minutes into this game. I don't know how many minutes, I've not been counting. We're surrounded. I will give the AI a little bit of thumbs up, because they do actually go out their way to surround you, and the civilians go out their way to fight back. Which is not what a lot of games do. Right, you hurt me, so I'm going to get my health back. I imagine that would only happen if I didn't pick up all the weapons, or the ammo, or whatever. You, give me back my health that you just took. Alright. I'm going to pay some ammo over here, which I just picked up. It seems I just walked past ammo. You can't really see it very well on the minimap. Oh, I've got maximum pistol ammo. Whoa. Whoa. Back up. Oh, this is the police department. That would explain the large amount of cops. Right, is anyone armed? It would appear there's at least one person armed in the back. Oh, it would appear I just clipped him then. Right, if I reload my shotgun. Two. Keep reloading, don't stop. Someone call the cops. You're inside the cop station. Already I have a gripe with the civilian chat.
A new year of genocide.
I suppose when you think about it, this game is so ridiculous, it probably would never happen. The fact that I get health, I'm getting health from killing people, is of course ridiculous. You can't look at this game with a straight face and say it's a realistic genocidal simulator, because it really isn't. Although I understand the controversy around this game, but it's buggy. Then again, it's only just been released, so expect bugs. But I see you. Stop being cute. Wow, they're all just standing on the ground now. I suppose that's the best way to... Because I'm just going to come for them anyway. Actually. What the... Things like that happen. Right, just get behind the wall. Behind the wall. Hug the wall. Ready. Damn. Cleanse the police station. Leave the district? I don't know what that means. I'm assuming that just means leave the area. So we escape now, somehow. And did I just beat the level?
I never thought it would be so easy.
I'm not going to watch the cutscenes simply because it's just the ravings of a madman. With a deep, grainy voice.
I like chocolate and bacon. Cleanse the filthy pigs.
Yes.
Come on, you fucking parasites. The death is waiting.
It would appear that I'm surrounded. I did expect this. What was going to happen? Alright, let's get my health back. Oh, it would appear. Oh, you keep ammo between missions? It would appear so. I have no AK ammo. I have full pistol ammo because I've not used my pistol much. You still alive? Give me health. Alright, so let's use the pistol because it's a little more maneuverable. And a little faster to reload. Is that a vagrant? It would appear so. No one shall escape this guy's wrath, I suppose. There we go. He's happy now. Okay. I wonder if I could make a hole in the wall. Or maybe I have to go up the ladder. Alright. That took a while to explode. Oh crap, apparently I'm burning. Right, I've found... Is that not a way out the sewers? Here, I have no idea. Oh, if you hold Alt. Oh, snap! Oh. Oh, why did nobody tell me of this sooner? I've now got a MP4. MP5, even. MP4. Whoa, snap! Did not expect that. Whew. Alright, so I actually like this level. This is a level I expect in the likes of like GTA and stuff. You know, you're trying to escape the cops. This is something that you would be doing in GTA. Especially in the sewers, through all those tunnels. Maybe not executing the police officers, but I suppose if they actually crawled around after you shot them, you would. But then again, you don't have to execute them, only if you need health. But then again, you can choose to die if you want. I suppose you're not really forced to do anything in this game. You're not forced to buy this game. That's the one thing that's driving me to disbelief throughout this whole controversy. It's your choice if you buy this game and play it or not. This game is not available to children. If children went to buy this game, I don't know if this is even getting a physical release, but I imagine if it did get a physical release and it was in stores, nobody would sell this game to a kid, and they would be in a lot of trouble if they did, because it's an adult-only game, and I don't think it's going to get a physical release anyway. But you don't have to buy this game. In fact, I'd recommend you don't buy this game if you're easily offended by things like these. But if you're interested in just a generic top-down twin-stick shooter like this, there are a lot more available for cheaper. Like I mentioned earlier, Alien Shooter, Zombie Shooter. There's a whole bunch. There's a million twin stick shooters out there. And if you enjoy twin stick shooters, I definitely recommend them over this one so far. But if you're interested in graphics, this is probably the best looking twin stick shooter I've ever played. I will give this game that much. It's absolutely beautiful. Because, like, I'm a huge zombie freak fan, so I love all blood and everything in video games. I like the gore and stuff. I like the blood physics. I like how the blood is red and everything's in black and white. Like I said, if you replaced all these with aliens or zombies, this game would feel absolutely phenomenal. And I guess, I suppose there's a lot of homeless bums in here. Let's hug them! Hug you. I suppose they're just health packs. Literally just lying health packs. Alright, I'll keep aiming over there. Alright, let's go. Oh, here comes some cops. Where are they? There they are. Ambush them. Did he just spawn there? Oh no, they're sliding down the ladder. Why do they bring a regular cop down here? Oh crap, are they infinitely spawning? I will never get out of here alive if they do. Right guys, it's time to stop spawning. Thank you, bye. I'm getting out of here, bye. Oh, health please. Thank you. Right. Random guy just stood there. I suppose he heard the shooting and was just confused. This MP4 is making this a hell of a lot easier. Reload the weapon. If you hold Alt, it'll highlight things, people you can heal from, and ammo around, and guns and stuff, and it appears there's a tear gas grenade there? Do I already have tear gas grenades? Oh! Do you mind? I'm pressing buttons on my keyboard! Thank you! Right. I think I just changed grenade to, like, tear gas, so we'll give tear gas a try if we ever come across a whole bunch of them. Let's bring some health back. It would appear there's some cops. At least a cop over there. Oh, snap. Right, if I chuck tear gas over there. Oh, no, it's not tear gas. It's a flash grenade. No, I need health. Actually, it went slow-mo, so I assumed I was low on health, but it would appear I'm not. Like I said, I've said before, the UI could be a hell of a lot better. Alright, let's get the heck out of here. There is a cop over here. Oh, there he is. I suppose it's a little cheaty if I just walk around like this, holding left alt. It shows up people so easily. Oh! Accidentally killed him. Reload, get all this ammo, find a way out the sewers. I'm just guessing here. I can't see that far. It would appear my view range isn't that good. Oh crap, I'm getting wrecked. Hello, thanks for the health. Ready, go! Oh yeah, they've got body armor, that's why they take so long to go down. Now the game suddenly makes a hell of a lot more sense to me. Alright, so this section is actually pretty enjoyable. Taking all... Because killing civilians, there. They don't really... Unless they fight back, it's not very fun, but... Walking around in these sewers, taking out these cops that are hunting me down, that's actually kind of fun. But I'm going to say this now before I get attacked by all the Tumblr people. I do not condone the killing of police officers, only video game police officers, because video games are not real and set in a virtual world where none of this is real. These are just pixels on the screen. In fact, I could reduce the pixel amount right now so less of them die? Less pixels die? Whoa, what the hell's wrong with you? You must have bugged out. Anyway, we'll go this way. I just feel like I'm walking around in circles now. I don't think I am, because I'm... Oh, no. I think I finally got to the exit. Boosh.
I think that's it. Time to leave this stinking place.
Alright, we got out the sewer. I thought that was going to be a good scene, and I thought I'd have to cut that out. It would appear not. Slaughter the marina residents, 80 remaining. Alright. So yeah, I wonder what this game would actually look like if it had colour. If everything was in full colour, I don't know if that would take away from the experience, or... let's just use a pistol for now. Don't want to waste too much ammo on these guys. We'll save the good ammo for the sport when they turn up. I suppose let's get into the video gamey world of this game. I'm only going to be making the one video of this game unless they make a tremendous update to this game, which I really doubt. I'll probably be playing this game from now until... I don't know, until I complete it, I guess, or get bored of it. I can see myself getting bored of it if this is all the gameplay has to offer. Because if this is it, just run to one location to the other, avoid the cops, don't die. I'd imagine it'd get harder and harder because the cops would get more onto you and kill you more. Yeah, this game could only be so fun for so long. Whoa, speaking of, finally got ourselves some action. Did I shoot that cop guy's head off? Cop guy. That cop's head off? Oh, I believe there's a cop over here. Oh no, it wasn't a cop, it was an armed citizen. American.
Sino 65, we've got a possible homicide.
Oh, possible? Yeah, totally has nothing to do with the nearby shootings in the neighborhood. Where the guy's still at large and a whole bunch of cops died and nobody had any radio contact in the sewers, apparently. I wanted to explode that thing. I'm gonna explode it anyway. Oh, is that gonna please sink? Oh, that's beautiful. That's actually really, really good. Oh, snap! I should have expected that. What do we got? Oh, snap! What? See, this is why this game's not a realistic rendition of slaughtering people. There's just a crate here with grenades on top of it, for no reason. I'm fairly certain this character did not place them there, and with all these people around, I'm fairly certain he definitely didn't leave them there. Because they would have just picked them up or reported them to police or something. Oh, snap! Snap, 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 snap. Stop being a hero. Oh, I got a respawn point. So I believe you don't actually get infinite respawns. That's also good. So that means if you die in this game, you have to start again when you run out of respawns. That's good. That's definitely good. That's very good, even. Because... But then again, it'd make it more video gamey if you could just infinitely respawn until you win. Because you definitely can't do that in real life. In fact, you can't respawn in real life anyway. God, I need to find my way out of here. Sprint around. And it looks like I've got infinite stamina as well. Trust me, having long hair, like I've got long hair, and having a long wet coat, because it looks like it's raining, you will not be sprinting for very long. Trust me. You could be the fittest person on earth, and you will not be sprinting as long as this guy's sprinting. A civilian! Hey!
What?
Ooh, he was picking something up. I think he was being cute.
Ooh, it was a shotgun. Nice.
Probably a good idea to get some cover. And there we go. Get this gun out. Alright, what do we got? We got a whole bunch of cops lining up for today! Rah! You didn't expect this. You thought I just had a pistol. There you go. That was relatively easy. There is a lot of pistol ammo. Let's reload my pistol. Like I said, the UI could be a hell of... I think it needs to be a lot bigger. I think I'd have less problem with it if it was bigger. Do you actually have a map? I don't know. I have no idea. Check out the hotel guest. Okay. Oh, don't waste ammo on him, Dan. Use pistol. I love how that person was casually just... Oh, snap! Oh! How am I not dead? Running through, just shooting all the pixels. Because they're about as interesting as... Why would people run into you? See, nobody in real life would do this. They would hear the gunshot and head for the nearest exit. And most certain... Oh, snap. We need to get the heck out of here. The cops have arrived. Actually, that might be a good spot. Good thinking, guys. There we go. All I've got now is a couple of windows, a couple of doors. Mostly. Nice. The controls are pretty solid. You just aim in the general direction you want to shoot. And you're pretty much good to go. Whoa, are you the one I shot before? Nice. Whoa! Did that civilian just spawn in front of me? Or fall through the wall? Well. Think about a bag. Oh, my health is definitely going down. I need to execute someone. Snap! Get the heck out of here, Dan. You, civilian. Damn it. I was hoping they'd give me some help. Damn, that's a lot of cops. Stop using a pistol. That might actually help. There we go. Right, is anyone alive enough for me to execute? Oh, these guys are. I've got full health again. There's plenty of ammo around. Don't actually think I need much. Civilian, come on. You can tell I'm the shooter. Can't you tell that I'm the shooter? You know, with guns and... long hair, and... You know, the one thing I don't actually like about this game is how stereotypical it is. Being an antisocial, hate-everybody, long-haired guy. Am I stuck? Oh no, the furniture's gone invisible. I see. Get out, fire! Because I've got long hair and I don't hate everybody. And I don't go on murderous rampages except in video games. Right? And then on the Tumblr people shout, "That's where it starts! I live in the UK! I wouldn't even know where the hell to get a gun." Alright, how long will we be going? About half an hour now. Alright, so... it would appear this game is the same gameplay, level to level. Probably not much happens. I'm going to keep playing this. It's actually a fun top-down shooter, I'd say. I use fun very lightly here. Enjoyable. I like fighting the cops. The civilian part is just, I don't know, a way of unlocking fighting the cops, I guess? Because that's one way I'm looking at it. Because the killing civilians part, I see them and I just go, if I shoot them, cops will come. And if the cops come, the game's enjoyment goes up. As you can just see, I just killed a couple of civilians and boom, three cops just came out of nowhere. But anyway, this is Hatred. Does it live up to the controversy? No. Does any game ever live up to the controversy? Probably not. So, do I recommend you buy it? If you love top-down shooters and you've got them all and you need the, and you want another that has great graphics, yeah, pick this up. If you don't like top-down shooters, don't get it. Don't buy this game. And if you definitely don't agree with the premise, definitely don't buy it. Why would you buy it? Why would you spend money and give the game developers money to leave a bad review on Steam, for example? It's just no purpose. These guys are shooting at me from a million miles away.
Shields can't stop me. Fucking cans.
Whatever that guy said. So yeah, I'm gonna call it here. I'm gonna finish the level, but I'm gonna stop the recording. Tell me what you guys think of the game. What do you guys think of the controversy surrounding this game? Is it really that well deserved? Did this game deserve an adult-only rating? Considering I could literally do this in GTA. I could literally walk up to civilians, mow them down in the street, and have cops come at me. And probably have a more fun time doing it because physics in GTA are hilarious. But then again, I suppose that's not... Like I said, I suppose it's all about context. The objective of this game is to kill civilians, kill as many people as possible, and then kill more cops. Whereas in GTA, you have the option. You're never forced to run up to civilians and mow them down, and then mow down all the cops. That's all optional. That's part of the side part of it. That's just a cause and effect kind of thing. If you kill civilians, you're going to get attacked by cops. So anyway, enough about this game, because I think it's outlived its welcome. Tell me what you guys think. I'll see you guys in the next video. Take care. Hehehehe